Right.
So, very good morning.
I'm Mel. Good. So this is my third year speaking here. I have been the MC for the same event in other countries. So if you are in Houston, LA, Chicago, London, you might have seen me before, or if you have participated in some of the online events, you might have seen me before. So this morning, I wanted to do something different. I think today, day two, is always a more exciting day. There's no noise, okay. So what I want to do is this. I want to acknowledge different countries. So here sitting in our midst, there are many, many people. I want to know where you are from, and let's get together. I'm going to have an activity that involves everyone. It's going to be reinforcing my message today. So can I have a show of hands? Who are from Malaysia? Malaysia? Okay. You must be proud of your country. Raise your hand high. Okay? Because these lights are shining on my face. I couldn't really see you. Okay. Indonesia? Alright, two. Thailand? Alright, one table here. Philippines? Woo! A lot. Korea. Oh, okay. Japan? Alright. Mongolia? India? Okay. Pakistan? Anyone I miss out? Myanmar? Of course. Where you guys from?
Nigeria.
Alright, okay. I almost go to Nigeria last year. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is this. I'm going to do a few things today. Number one, I'm not going to go through every slide because you get the slides. You can take your time to digest them. Number two, I'm going to have conversation with all of you in a different way. Because you have heard from many people, I think it's a good time now at day two in the morning to hear from each other. Number three, when I do the actual presentation, I'll be talking about a lot of things you do not like to hear. So is it okay if we do an icebreaker right now that has to do with marketing automation? Are you all game to do real engagement? We should stop talking about engagement. We should start practicing engagement. Because some of the most successful social media marketing strategies I know, they are also the most socially inept people on earth. I'm not joking, because they can be so successful in their campaign, but when you check them out on LinkedIn, you found nothing. Absolutely nothing, all right? Their Facebook, they update once in 2 years, all right? And when they go to conferences like this, they don't post anything using the hashtag. But they promote the company hashtag as if their life depended on it. So I'm going to ask my colleagues right now to distribute a lot of cards to you. So can each of you take two of these beautiful cards I'm going to pass around? All right. So if there are some fine gentlemen who are willing to help her, it'll be great. Okay, wonderful, guys. Nobody's moving. Okay, every table should have a stack of cards. Every one of you take two cards. Take two cards. So guys, there's another reason why I do this, is to get your energy up. Because most of the time in a conference like this, the energy is so cold, nobody is talking, no one is moving, nobody is doing anything to help the speakers to be more engaging. So we need to do this together. We need to automate our engagement. All right, so this is a good start. So make sure you have at least two cards with you. Now, before I explain the rule, I want to explain something to you. These cards are very expensive cards. So please do not put it in your pocket. Please do not put it in your bag. They have to return to me after the game. That's number one. Okay? So, can I have two cards? Can I have two? Yes. Thank you, Tony. By the way, Tony is doing a good job as MC, right? Can you please give him an applause? Yeah, good. Yeah, he's so good that on rare occasion when he's not doing it, I'll be doing it. All right, so can I have a volunteer? I'm going to make this very interactive. Can I have a volunteer to come on stage? Any volunteer? Thank you very much. Please give this lady a round of applause. You know what? As you're coming up, because you volunteer, you're going to get a book from me after the session. Okay? So please come. All right. That's very good. Thank you. All right. So this is what you're going to do. In a moment, would you stand here? Yeah. In a moment, I'm going to invite you to stand, and I want you to go around the room to get to know as many people as possible. You do not need to think about anything to say. They are all in your cards. This is how you do it. Okay, assuming I do not know her, I will walk around the room and I will introduce myself. Hi, I'm Andrew.
Hi, I'm Hawa.
Hawa, okay.
Hawa.
Hawa. Wow, we have Huawei, now we have Hawa. By the way, my Chinese name is Kokwa. Okay, so this is what you're going to do. You face down, all right, the words face down, and face down, I will choose one card from you. You will do likewise. Okay, so this is the rule of the game. Listen. Whichever card you pick, you have to read out the question to her, and you have to answer this question concisely. There are two ways to play this game. One is to be honest. Two is to pretend to be honest. Because they are all very personal questions that requires you to think about something. All right? So, after I have answered her in a very concise way, one or two sentences, now it's her turn. Okay, so just to demo, this is my question. What do others say you are good at? I think it's obvious, right? Talking. That's why they invite me to be a speaker. All right, so that's my answer. What about yours?
Would you consider joining politics and why?
Oh, that's very interesting, especially in your country. Okay, would you like to answer that?
Yes,
or no?
Sure.
Okay, yes. Come.
I've always wanted to join the Senate because I feel like they have the most power in the country to make a difference.
Wow, join the Senate. Okay. So in a few years' time, I hope I will get a better reception when I go to your country.
Yeah,
let's give her a round of applause. Okay. So thank you very much. Come. Okay. Now this is what you do after you have finished. Q&A, two sides, whichever card that you have picked, you keep. And you go to another person, and you play this game all over again. All right, don't be shy to shake my hand. All right, I want you in the next 5 minutes to walk around the room to get to know people you have never talked to. Now, everyone must stand up. Everyone must play this game. If you're answering your email and you're sitting down, I will go behind you. I will read your email to everyone. So you can't play this game with the people you know. You have to walk across the room. Are you ready? Are you ready? Let's go. Do we have music? Let's go across the room. Go to someone you do not know.
It might be a bit loose, like connection. Did you maybe unplug it through your jacket?
Yeah. Can you play music? All right. Please get to know as many people as possible. Sit down, no one sit down. Hello, I'm doing the 360 here. Wow, this is good. This is a good one.
She turned around and said, walk this way.
Oh. Remember, once you are done, go to someone else. Once you are done, go to someone else. You be your mother's child, I'll never fail. Go to someone else, you got 2 more minutes. Let's wrap this up in 2 more minutes. She turned around and said, walk this way. Okay, 1 more minute, and when you are done with this current conversation, take a seat. All right, once you're done, please go back to your place and take a seat. All right, thank you. Once you're done, go back to your place.
Today you look very good. You look like volunteer. Look like participant more. There's an orange t-shirt.
Oh, yeah. It's okay.
But I'll tell you something, right? Don't wear orange t-shirt in Malaysia too much. If you're coming, happen to be in our country.
Why?
Thank you very much. Okay. Let's go back to your place. Once you're done with this current conversation.
So you see the TV, normally those can wear like the convict, they go to court for trial, they wear orange t-shirt.
Thank you very much.
In our country, they wear yellow.
Yeah. But our one is in famous orange t-shirt, then we will hashtag you.
Thank you. Let's go back to your place.
So I got one of my story yesterday.
Nice.
I'm going to try this stuff.
Thank you very much.
The bakery.
Let's go back to your place.
The master of the bakery.
In Malaysia?
No, he's a Polish guy. But I think quite a while in Singapore. So he's got...
I saw a pickup. Alright, please go back to your place and put the cards on the center of the table.
Okay. Okay, let's sit down now, please. Thank you, everybody. Let's sit down, please.
Yeah, let's sit down.
What's his name?
Go for the global bakery. Because I was trying this, that's why I was drinking yesterday. I was like.
Thank you, let's sit down.
Did you eat that?
Yeah.
You are so responsive, so engaging.
Yeah.
It's been an absolute pleasure playing this with you. All right. We're going to wait for another 10 seconds for you to finish your conversation. Whoever left standing, after 10 seconds, will have to do something. Thank you. Let's go back to your place. Thank you. So, can I ask you something? Are you energized now? Was the game good? Did you realize something? When I asked you to start this game, some of you were doing this. You move so slowly. But after 1 or 2 rounds, I've been telling you to stop for the last 5 minutes. I've said it 10 times. No one heard me. We learned something about this activity. Number one, automation it's always hard to begin, especially marketing automation. It needs some getting used to. Number two, once you get a hang of it, it becomes an unconscious competence. You find that a lot of your stuff are automated. You become more productive, you have more energy for more important things. Now I need to do this because so many times in a conference, we get head knowledge, we get a lot of knowledge. We simply can't have enough time to develop a skill. But I want to tell you something. Marketing automation is an attitude. Marketing automation, it's something that you have to walk the talk, not because of the things you need to automate, not because you need to be more productive, but because customer journey is always evolving. Customer is king has never been more pronounced today. Today, even for yourself, you are a customer, you become more demanding. You need more personalized services, and because of that, you have high demand for brand engagement. And today, I'm going to ask you many, many questions that requires you to think about the answer. Because today, I believe a lot of us are just doing our work, but we never think about the future. We never think about human psychology, and we definitely never think about the customer journey. So, this is my handle. This is my handle. Please contact with me if you are on Twitter, if you're on Instagram. All right, I'm on almost every platform, except Snapchat, of course. Okay? I've written 3 books. I've just given 1 away. I will be giving out another 4 as I go along. Let's forget about this. I want to just focus on the theme today. Oh yeah, this one. So I had 5 different disruptive careers. So just by looking at the year, you can guess how old am I. I served a few years with the government, and then a few years with retail, Kodak. Everybody remember this logo, right? How many of you have taken pictures using a negative before? Wow, okay, you have been around for a long time. Definitely. All right. And then I went to do events like this. I was in MICE for a few years, and then I become a matchmaker. That was long before social media was active. I was the only guy in Singapore doing matchmaking. I matchmake men to women only, and not others. But by about 2009, something emerged. Social media becomes very rampant, and I know one day it will overrun my business. So true enough today, right? No one is interested to find matchmaker like me. Everybody just download the app called Tinder. Do you know what Tinder is? If you don't know, I give you a coaching during lunchtime. All right, your life will be very, very colorful. And for those of you who say you don't know, I think you are lying. Yeah, right? If I check my phone, I definitely find the app inside there. All right, so right now I'm doing a lot of speaking and training. I also started a media startup. So I'm going to talk about some salient points today. This is a definition. It's technology, it's also an attitude. But the problem is this, technology has so many fronts. It's not about embracing technology, it's about embracing the integration of different technology. How many of you in your own company, you have at least 3 or 4 or 5 independent systems that's not integrated running your company? Yeah, only one. The rest? Okay. The rest? You have only one system, right? That's why you don't need to integrate. Of course, we have no trouble adopting one technology, but we have trouble integrating them. And whose job is it to integrate them? It's ourselves, right? So, what does it really do? Besides saving our time, it is about helping you to scale and grow. Even for people like me, I use a one-size-fits-all CRM called Kartra. Alright, it's for SME and for solopreneur only. So if you are small setup, Kartra is really good for you. Alright, because it is actually created by marketer. A lot of the system that you want to purchase, they are created by data scientists. Right? So if you purchase something from LinkedIn Sales Navigator, they give you a 2-hour training. Anyone from LinkedIn here? Okay, so they give you training, but the training is only done on webinar, and it's 2 hours. They tell you functionally what you need to do, but they didn't tell you how exactly to leverage it for marketing. So we're going to study that. Now, different people have different definition of automation, but we all agree it involves a few of this. So how many of you, you are still actively doing email marketing? Wow, only 10. Oh. How many of you, you have great landing page for a lot of your campaign? You have like A-B testing again? Very few. Okay. How many of you, you invest a lot in SEO and SEM? Hey, I'm seeing the same hands all the time. What about the rest? Okay. So, I need to change. So, how does it really work? There are four segments. You need to collect data. And data is something that is often misinterpreted and underemphasized. Do you collect data? What is your data requirement? What is your big data requirement? In order to understand data, you need to practice automation on a personal level. So I'm going to now run another activity, very simple. I just need you to take out your phone. Please take out mobile phone. How many of you, you're on LinkedIn? Great. Today, I'm going to show you how we can connect to each other without exchanging name cards, without talking to each other. So can you open your LinkedIn app? Open your LinkedIn app, and there is a function. Can this get down? All right, you're on your LinkedIn app. Can you see my network underneath? Don't look at me, look at your phone. All right, my network, can you click on it? If your app is new, can you see that there is a button on the right bottom, blue, with this guy, plus? Can you click on this? Can you find that there is the option at the very last one, find nearby? Yeah. Can you switch that to on and make sure that your Bluetooth is on? You will be led to this landing page under LinkedIn, and if everybody is doing what I'm doing, you will see people appearing on this page itself. All right, do you have it? Okay, no, click on this one. Are you logged on to your system? Okay, this one. Switch it on. All right, so Jasmine Ching, where are you? All right, so is it, I can see Jasmine right now, and I know that we are not connected. All right, there are only four of us who are now on LinkedIn, who are in this room, who are present. All right, you don't need data, you don't need Wi-Fi, you only need your Bluetooth. I'm just showing you, we need to walk the talk, we need to embrace little tools that make us more productive. LinkedIn is one of them. Now, if you keep this page on, more and more people who join in, you'll be connected. But after this period, if you go out during lunchtime, don't expect to see this list anymore. Because once you close this page, everyone disappears. So I can now simply go and connect to everyone. I will invite everyone. And as a marketer, I think it's good practice that we connect to more friends. Yes? So please go ahead to connect to everyone in this room so that you can check out each other during lunchtime itself. Okay, so I'm going to leave this page on for a while. Okay, who didn't get it? Who still lost? Okay, go to my network. There is a button on the right bottom. Click on it. You will see find nearby. Switch it on. Switch find nearby to on, and you will find that technology enables you to connect to many people. Why do I do this with you? We need to walk the talk for technology. We need to embrace technology. I talked to one guy yesterday. He said he loved automation, he hates technology. See, these two go hand in hand. It's like flying and travel. You love travel, you're going to love flying, although a lot of us hate it. But it goes hand in hand. So when you can collect data, you begin to segmentize. You begin to be able to create a user experience for different type of users. And of course, this part has to do with consumer. For yours, it's about workflow and delivery. So automation is not just about us, it's about automating the way you collect information and the way you handle information. The question is, do you have the right information? If you're not connected to fellow digital marketer, we're always operating in silos. So this conference itself is a good way to connect with people. I know a lot of you fly many hours to Singapore and you're sitting together with your friends, right? You see, you're sitting together as a group. You're sitting together as a group. You should actually connect. You need to connect. Now, when the marketing automation stops, it stops around here. The minute when you have a qualified lead, that it goes into an accepted prospecting process, the sales take over. The sales take over. So if you have Salesforce, all right, primarily you are actually focusing on the sales automation. You are focusing on first meeting all the way to closing. But this is where the fun is. You know, until today, I still get very perturbed when management says marketing is a cost center. How many of you, your organization is still telling you are a cost center? Are you a cost center? We are a smart money center. We must be smart so that the sales can do their thing, right? So look at this carefully. Are you leading your client, or are you leading a lead through a systematic process that you can automate until finally it's able to meet you, you qualify them, and you're able to talk to them, have the first meeting? It's very important. LinkedIn is one good platform that you can find as many leads as you can. Really, we are spending so much money on lead generation, we forgot that we're sitting on a pot of gold mine. There are so many people out there that we have not been connecting to. We need to do that right now. So if you're not active on LinkedIn personally as a marketer, you need to be on LinkedIn. So I'm going to skip this. All of you know, I'm going to go to... So these are 10 things. So I'm going to do this by now. I have half an hour. I'm going to do this. I'm going to divide you guys into 10 different groups. So we have 20 tables, I believe. So table 1 and 2, where are you? Okay, table 1 and 2 got no one. It's only two of you, right? Okay, so maybe can 1, 2, 3, and 4, you can combine. Okay? And you can talk about what makes a good email marketing system. All right? Just compile as many short points as you can. And later on, I'm going to pass the mic around and for you to share in 10 seconds. So I'm going to give you 5 minutes to discuss your wish list for everything. What makes a great system? I only give you 2 minutes to discuss quickly. Somebody will write down the points. And we hope to collate all this. At least I will collate all this. And then I will be emailing to you should you be connected to me on LinkedIn itself. So table 1 to 4, can you do email marketing? 5 to 6, table 5 and 6? 5 and 6? No, 1 and 6, okay, no. 7, 8, can you do landing page? Okay, discuss what makes a great landing page. 9 to 10, web traffic analytics. What are the top 10 things you look for? 9, 10, 11, 12. Campaign management. What makes a great campaign management? 11, 12. 13, 14. Lead management. Okay? 15, 16? Asset, digital asset management. 16. 17, 18? 17 and 18? These two? Yeah? Okay. Can you do web content management? 17 and 18. All right, discuss among yourself. This is the one. 19, 20, you do social media marketing. All right. Now, the rest behind, you can choose the last two. Behavior, tracking, and revenue analytics. Give me as many pointers as you can on what makes a good system. All right. So can I give you 2 minutes, discuss in your table, and somebody write down a list. Only 2 minutes. Your time starts now. This is the time we learn from each other. We need to collate every good things together. All right. So if you need to join table, please do so. You have 2 minutes.
Web traffic analytics, we use UTM tracking to track our campaign traffic to our website. Something that I've found really useful in the past is actually looking at the IP address of the traffic, because then you can see if they're working at a government department.
All right, can you hear me?
United Nations, where your traffic is coming from.
If you're not clear on the topics you need to discuss, please go to a table. Look at this carefully. We need every brain in this conference to collate a list of key features required for every sector in marketing. So if you need a system, what key features do you think is absolutely necessary in every sector? So think about it.
So the one who does that is an analyst, right?
You have 2 more minutes. For example, email marketing, if you say that I need A/B testing, all right, which I think is important, if that is important, then it must be included, right?
For a software company based in Ireland, so we have this product that can automate the...
If your email marketing needs to be integrated with another system at the back end, and if that feature is absolutely important to you, it should be inside the list.
The company's Planet Verify.
That's very good.
Do you usually go?
I think 13 and 14 are very engaging.
Do you go to
this is the type of energy we need in a conference. We need to learn from each other. It's very good. Give yourself a round of applause. All right, thank you. Very good, very good.
But then we are also using UTM tracking for content, so sponsored editorial that we're posting through sites like Study International, just to make sure first of all, to see which links people are clicking on and where the links are coming from.
Do you think we can use it for the
yeah. Using a case study like your what the number of country clicks from.
Yeah, that type of things we are doing, but not in detail.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, we've got 1 more minute. Let's wrap up. And please appoint a spokesperson because we're going to throw that mic around very soon.
From each country, how many
don't worry, we will be compiling all this and we'll be sending it to you, but you need to contribute. All right, got 30 seconds more to wrap up.
Website.
15 seconds. Let's wrap up the discussion. 15 seconds. All right.
Coming through this website called the Master of Laws Guide, which we've never advertised on. So I followed that back to the website.
This is a masterclass. So we need to learn from each other. All right. So can I trouble your name? Okay, sorry. Okay. Can you throw the cash box to... okay, which one of you would like to share? Can I have attention? Which one of you would like to share? Okay, maybe here. All right, landing page. Oh no, sorry, email marketing. All right, so now if you're still discussing, you can still write down the points, but please listen to every group because I'm going to do this quickly. And whatever list you have, can you take a picture of that list and share it on Twitter using the hashtag so that we can compile them? All right, please write down the heading. Okay, so let's do it.
Okay, so we had the most important thing,
email marketing, let's listen,
for email marketing as the getting past the spam filters, so like the credibility with the email provider, because otherwise you end up in the inbox argument. The second was the title needs to be interesting, engaging, and like stand out. It also needs to have a good preview text. We had the timing is important. We try and time our emails to be around to be sent around like 8:30.
I think you are mistaken. You are telling me best practices.
Oh, best practice.
Yeah, you are telling me best practices. But what I want is, what should a good email marketing platform or a system or a CRM? What key features do you expect the system to offer you? All right, yeah. It's not about best practices. It's not about what is good. It's about what kind of feature you want the system to have. All right, but it's all good. How many of you are as mistaken as our fine, handsome gentleman here? All right, okay, so half. It's okay, you can still repair it, buy some time. All right, now, So that list is good. Can you change it to best practices and then share it on Twitter using this hashtag so that we can get a lot of content from you?
Okay,
so do you have any other features to contribute? How about this group? Group three? Same thing. All right. You see, that's the thing. We are so occupied with doing our work well, we forget that someone or something else can help us automate. So if you think that the title of the email marketing got to be engaging, interesting, exciting, if you have a system that can randomly generate title suggestion to you, then that would be a key feature in email marketing because it can generate a lot of suggestion. So if suggestion is important, then that has to be the key feature because you need to be exciting in at least the subject matter. So that is what I'm talking about. Okay, how about we switch to landing page 5 and 6, right? No, sorry, 7 and 8. 7 and 8, landing page. I hope you got it right. Okay, so can you throw the... Just throw it to them, just throw it to them.
Yeah.
Just throw it to them. All right, so give me concisely all the key feature in landing page. If you have a landing page system,
yes.
What would you like?
Okay, the user interface design must be attractive, colorful, and engaging.
Intuitive, all right.
The landing page should be mobile friendly because most people spend their times on their phones.
Okay.
It should be optimized for search engine optimization should also be
okay
included.
SEO friendly.
Yes, SEO friendly.
Okay.
Then it should carry simple, clear, and important information, and it shouldn't be too busy.
All right. So, what you have said is again the best practice. So let me fill in the blank for you. Okay. You need a good landing page system to do the following: integration with other platform, your web page, your social media pages.
Okay.
You need integration.
Like
that's number one. Number two,
like
you need plenty of mobile responsive templates for different industry. That is again another key feature, right? Okay. You may need it on cloud. So like if you are a subscriber on leadpage.net, I think you have everything there. So that is a classic case of functions. How many functions do you have to enjoy competitive advantage? How you need a lot of functions, you need a lot of help so that you can be more productive. That is what I'm saying. So you may have your own wish list, but you need this wish list to be met by different functions of any system you want to purchase. All right. Okay. So thank you very much. Remember, take a picture, share this information using the hashtag so that we can all access to it. All right. Can you do that?
We've done that already.
Done that already. That's very good. Awesome. What about three? Web analytics. We need to move quickly. 9 and 10. Who's going to share? Let's throw the box over to here. Who's going to share? Anyone? Put up a hand, please. Thank you. Yes.
Okay, so we talked about how for web traffic analytics, we want something that allows us to measure and monitor our campaign performance.
Mm.
And to be able to do that, we'd need to be able to integrate it with our campaign platforms.
Yes.
And to be able to have reporting templates that we can customize so that we can drill down to see the sources that our traffic are coming from, and to be able to look at the demographics of our traffic as well, so their age, their geographic location, their behavior on site, what they've clicked on, and where they go to afterwards as well.
Sure. Wow, that's a very, very good list. And if I may add, if you want analytics, you got to be very well versed with GA, Google Analytics. So if you want to be trained to fully utilize GA, you got to get certified. You got to go deep. You got to go into funneling. You can go into events. Just be an expert in Google Analytics. I think that will be able to solve most of the issues. A lot of us are just users. We look at a graph, okay, and that's it. You got to look at your bounce rate. You got to look at, and which page are they exiting? You got to look in between information. You got to look for intelligence. A lot of people, when they look at the same thing, they get different story. You remember the song, some see more, some see less, some see nothing at all. A lot of us, when we look at analytics, we see nothing at all. So make sure that you specialize in GA. Okay. Number four, campaign management. Campaign management.
What?
Who is sharing? Please decide a spokesperson. All right, we can move quickly. We are already behind time. All right, so whatever list you have, remember to share. So let's shoot. What key features do you need a campaign manager to have?
For campaign management, I think we already have a lot of campaign management platforms such as DoubleClick, Campaign Manager, and whatnot. But I think it lacks comparison among campaigns. So I think it's important for us to have a to compare campaign performances between brands and get benchmarks across marketing objectives.
Okay, so comparison of different campaign, yes. The ROI and the reach.
Yes.
Right? And the engagement level.
Yes.
So that's one point. So that's very important. Number two? Anyone? Any more?
Really detailed like targeting.
Yes,
features.
Thank you.
For example, like demographics, geographics, and our target audience's preference, their likes.
Sure.
We would want to like manage all that.
Yes. You got to be able to manage that targeting and retargeting.
Yes.
Not just demography, but psychography. That is very important. You have to make sure you do a thorough user persona. When was the last time we do the user persona? Or if you're B2B, it's a buyer persona. Persona is so important. It's basically what do you think your customer will feel, will think, and do. Whether they have income level, their house type, whether they own a car, whether their gender, are not important in today's marketing. Not as important as knowing what is their biggest challenges, their biggest motivation, their fear, their excuses of not buying. Where are they looking for information? All these are important. And as a good campaign manager is able to draw data from your persona. You got to keep updating the persona so that your campaign can be very, very targeted. And that is how Facebook make their money. If you are very targeted, you can actually have a very, very low cost per click itself. All right? Less than 0.01%. So thank you. All right. We have time for just one more. Maybe can I skip and can I go to social and mobile marketing? Who is doing it? All right. Please hold the mic. Thank you. I like it that all of you are sitting together. I want to do this before I wrap up something. Okay, let's shoot. Remember, even if you don't have a chance to share your list, can you please take a picture and share this on Twitter itself? Let's go.
Hi. Okay, so some of the key features I think are necessary for social media is to meet the customers at every point of need. So if you have a holistic approach, you can listen to their conversations on Twitter, you can create groups for them on Facebook, and on Instagram you can create an aesthetic appeal that shows them the type of, shows them how your products can be used. A soft sell on product marketing, and as well as show the company culture, what the company is doing with, in terms of community engagement. So that's a holistic approach. Then another necessary key feature on social media is would be automation in the form of chatbots on Facebook. So if you can automate a lot of the common responses, if you've been listening to what your customers have been saying in your showrooms, if you have any, or on Twitter, you can then begin to come up with ready responses to questions they might have, such as you know how they can interact with the brand, the common questions they might ask, and this saves you a lot of process and increases the speed in which you respond to your customer requests.
Okay.
So thirdly, analytics. I think the digital marketing space applies a lot with social media marketing. So you can get a lot of feedback on what is working, what isn't working, as well as in general. Let me say you can get analytics about how your customers feel about products, how your customers feel about the brand, and how your customers are actually using the brand or using the products, as the case may be. So what you can now do in this situation is that you can use these analytics to create better customer profiles, to create better products, and going forward you can use it to tend to know where your customers are going. If your customers are gradually beginning to lean towards certain competitors or certain brands, you can begin to look at that and say, okay, what is it that they are doing that we're not doing?
Okay. If you ever know that system, please tell me, because this is a very comprehensive one. Okay, it's about social media marketing. But what you are saying is great. It's the overall overview, but for social media marketing, we just need some key features. All right. So thank you very much for your contribution. Can you just share that list on Twitter? If you are taking picture for conference, this is one slide you have to take. Because this is really, if you are putting your money onto a platform, onto marketing automation platform, platform that can do this, it's only basic. Anyone can manage your database, can manage your leads, can do your email. These are all basic. In fact, basic, it's not desirable. Next level, if your platform, if a few of these automation is able to help you to do social media marketing, mobile, and help you to research on online advertising, paid search, helps you to do SEO, helps you to analyze your keywords, and so on, helps you to manage channel, these are really standard. Very, very standard. Very standard automation. Now, you look higher. What is it that will make a very comprehensive system is all this plus lead pages, web form, web analytics, visitor tracking, multiple channel, leads capturing, scoring. Scoring for leads are very important. Marketing automation is a big topic, but the best practices is really this. Automation, it's about being more productive and giving user a more pleasant experience. Today, there's so much talk about AI, so much talk about chatbots. I think you have to consider chatbots, virtual assistant as part of this automation. You have to understand new skills. You have to learn what is really machine learning and natural language processing. Today, if you're based in Singapore, you can still capture leads in Malaysia, in Thailand, in Indonesia. Just by making a chatbot multilingual, you can capture a lot of different leads. And you gotta understand how technology works. You gotta integrate everything together. You gotta learn how human beings speak to each other. How human beings, there are so many ways. If I buy insurance and I wanna make a claim, if I have an accident, I have many ways to ask the same question. You have different ways of asking how to make a claim. And every one of us are doing different things. How will the machine be able to understand that 10,000 we are asking the same thing is really about down to what is the claim? That is something we as marketers, we need to understand technology. We need to understand AI. AI will not replace us. They only replace a lot of tasks. If our job is only about a lot of tasks, we will be replaced one day. If we don't manage automation, automation will one day manage us. So today, there are a lot of partners out there who are into automation. Please visit everyone. You need to know how it works, even though you're outsourcing it. Let's face it this way. So there are vendors who are specialized in outsourced as a service. There are vendors who are into chatbots. Please speak to everyone. There's also a vendor out there who automate your influencer marketing campaign. They have an AI solution that can validate influencers following their real engagement. They do research on your behalf. All right? Short of matchmaking their influence with your brand message. So go and find who are they. I'm not going to tell you the name because they didn't pay me to say it. All right? But if you want to share about your take on marketing automation, if you want to share about your take on digital marketing, during lunchtime, or at least yesterday, you will see a booth. It's a podcast studio. It's a very nice giant sofa-like booth that rests around. I'll be sitting there. If you would like to share something on air, I'm having a live stream, so I'll be very glad to invite you. I'll be going around lunchtime. I'll be speaking to every one of you. If you are keen to share something on air, live, you're welcome to do so. So let's keep the conversation going. I have 5 minutes. Is there anyone who have any question before I wrap this up? Anyone? Okay, if not, I'm going to ask you this. Your action plan. What are two things you're going to do, you're going to try immediately in the next 2 weeks? There are a lot of automation that give you 30 days trial. LinkedIn Sales Navigator is one of them. If you're not signed up, yeah, 30 days free, you got to think about your objective. Try it out. For example, in the next 2 weeks, you're going to try out LinkedIn Sales Navigator for free for 30 days. Do it. Have a game plan. Check out the functions and see if it's aligned to your objective. Number two, I'm very sure after listening to everyone, there are things that you know you have done wrongly. What are two things that you know that you got to stop doing in marketing? Because they don't work for you. They don't have the KPI. They don't give you the ROI. They're just wasting your time. What are two things you need to stop doing in your marketing right now? And the last question is very, very important. What are two things I've been doing well in marketing? I need to continue. You need to know that. That is why taking notes of your journey as a marketer, of your job performance every 2 to 4 weeks is important. You need to document what you have been doing great, because your boss is going to ask you, how's it going? Is it working for us? And you have to be the one. They're going to tell them, I have done a lot of homework. I've done before and after. I can safely tell you that we have met our KPI because we have done our research. Remember, automation is really about attitude. It's not so much of a skill. You only need a few days to master a platform, but you need a lifetime to embrace automation as attitude. Because if you don't change, the customer will go away. And I hope this is a message you take away. If you want to increase your ROI, you have to increase your customer engagement, just like what we did earlier on in the session. And with that, thank you very much for listening. Enjoy your lunch, and I'll see you at the booth. Thank you.